to allow the presidential candidate to the highest number of votes and the runners-up to automatically form a coalition government. In his proposal to the Building Bridges Initiative, Mudaura said the winner in a presidential election should become the president and the head of state and appoint the runners-up as a prime minister. He said the position of the deputy president should not be abolished for succession purposes.
Inch. People who are going to be number two are not going to conduct a campaign of name calling. It will not be a name calling because he knows very well the other fellow is likely to be his partner in government. The number one was is not going to conduct a campaign because even to know he is going to be number one. Is not going to conduct a campaign of name calling, which is really personalized, becomes bitter, and people cannot work. Now they will be working on issues. And there is no problem with people disagreeing on issues. You know, if it's issue-based politics, there is absolutely no problem. And then the other thing is, we have seen people operate from different, very different positions. For example, during 2007, you remember Uhuru and Ruto were in very opposite and very antagonistic camps, which you remember resulted into all those things that we had. But in 2013, they were together, forming a Jubilee. They worked very well, and they have been working very well. Raila the other day was being sworn as people's president. Today, they are working very closely with the president. So what I'm saying here is that let us, you know, our constitution, the way it would be, it is formed here, is to tame our politicians. Tame them so that they are concentrated more on issues, and they concentrated more on positive, competitive politics.
Well, let's bring in the political analyst Javas Bigambo joining us by way of phone. Javas, the former head of public service, they're calling for the reintroduction of the office of the prime minister. His argument here is that an all-inclusive government is likely to be a permanent guarantee for national cohesion in the country. Your thoughts on the same?
Thank you so much, Michelle. The proposals by the former head of public service, Francis Muzaura, are stirring as they are interesting. One, when you look critically at his views, yes, while they propose the issue of an all-inclusive government and the fact that it's not about the winner take it all, a few critical thoughts then emerge. When you look at our constitutional framework today, it provides that in the event that the sitting president is incapacitated, or dies or resigns, the deputy president takes office automatically. Mm-hmm. Now, if we're to embrace the proposals by Ambassador Muzaura, if at all the first runners-up or the person who obtained the second highest votes forms a coalition government with the winner, and the position of deputy president is retained for succession purposes, in case the president is incapacitated or resigns or dies in office, will it be in the place of the deputy president to succeed automatically? Will it be the place of now the principal partner in the coalition government, who was the first runners-up, to take over and succeed as president, or do we go to election? That will be another issue of contest in terms of succession. Mm-hmm. In terms of hierarchy, will the coalition partner, the principal coalition partner, who was the first runners-up in the past election, become senior to the deputy president, or will the deputy president be senior to the coalition partner? Those are critical issues that, of course, will emerge in terms of jostling for power Remember that in the Grand Coalition government, there was such jostling between Vice President, as he then was, Kalonzo Musyoka, and Prime Minister Raila Odinga, as he then was, in terms of seniority, in terms of protocol and recognition, etc.
Right. Let's bring in the opposition and the role of the opposition then in such a setup of government, because at the end of the day, from his what he said yesterday, the president's party then will provide the leader of government business, with the prime minister's party nominating his or her deputy. So where does that leave the opposition, and will it be as strong as is intended to be?
First, let's appreciate that in principle, in democratic praxis, the person who garners the second highest votes that party becomes the official opposition.
Right.
Now, in this proposal, that party is part of government. Even though, for instance, the Prime Minister then proposes the deputy leader of government business in parliament, etc., when it comes to shouldering the burden or the successes of a particular regime, will it be the ruling party or the party of the majority that will claim the successes and even the failures, or will the supportive party, the coalition partner, shoulder also as well the successes or the failures of that regime?
Mm-hmm.
Then the other thought is that effectively, technically it sounds a death knell to opposition politics. Remember that in traditional political lexicon, an opposition party is a shadow government or a government in waiting. And it may be having proposals or policy propositions that are diametrically opposed to those of the ruling party of the day. So in this case, if all of them are in government, then in the event or to the extent that they are opposed to whatever extent, whether it's matters of budgetary proposals, whether it's matters to do with our policies or matters to do with certain pieces of legislation, if at all there is such kind of opposition, will it not bring some kind of wrangling and some kind of technical political balancing within that arrangement? However, the genius of that proposal is that it kind of eliminates post-election chaos, because when you look at the post-election malaise that encumbered Kenya in 2007-2008, it was a question of an election being too close to call, and then the issue of the manner in which the election is conducted, and the runners-up not accepting the election outcome. So here, the issue of contesting the election still will not die, but at least the first runners-up will be sure of having a place in the shade within government leadership.
All right. Many thanks. That is Jarvis Bigambo, political analyst. They're responding to submissions of the former head of public service, Francis Mdaura, yesterday, speaking to the Building Bridges Initiative. Mdaura calling for the reintroduction of the office of the prime minister, as well as the expansion of the executive to create an all-inclusive government. We'll continue with that conversation later on. But for now, take a short break here on News Centre. Do stay with us. Still more news making headlines on the other side.